I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting.
You know what I'm saying?
Now everybody's fighting everybody.
Now everybody's fighting everybody. It's what the sport used to be. It's what it should be, you know? So now...
You can look at Gabe and can tell he has boxed so many rounds with Bernard Hopkins.
You boxed. He said you could look at you and tell you did a lot of rounds with Bhop.
You could see...
You could see that?
Oh, my
But you're from Philly, so you would know that.
Yeah, but Bhop got a certain style.
He's a very smart, very smart fighter.
And he got, like, rounds in from when Gabe was coming up.
What's happening is, like... At this point in my career, a lot of the shit I did with them, I'm picking up on it.
Now it makes sense.
Like now it's just like, there's certain moves I do, I get why.
Yeah,
I didn't understand it before. I get it.
And no one taught you, you just picked it up.
But he used to be it.
No, but I'm saying, it's not like Bhop.
No,
but I'm saying, you just picked it up naturally. It wasn't like he sat down with you and explained to you what is the...
He always teach me, but honestly, sometimes... You can tell a fighter so much, but until he goes through it in the ring,
he won't,
then it's like, oh shit.
Yeah.
And sometimes that's what experience is all about.
Well, that's a big compliment from Malik to say that he could see Bhop in you.
You go through certain fights, and you just pick up on it.
He's not running.
I got this slick shit for Danny Jacob Ass. He just got to hope he don't get caught in the chin. Because I don't even know if he's going to beat that guy. But even if he take an L, I still fight him. It ain't about his belt.
Duchenko, is that his name?
Huh?
The guy he's fighting?
I don't know, but I know the guy he's fighting.
Derechenko. The guy only has very few fights, right?
The guy hasn't fought that much. He's a good fighter, but now he's fighting. It's not a guaranteed win for Danny Jacobs. Definitely not a guarantee.
Are you going to be there ringside?
Huh?
You going to be there ringside?
No.
They're fighting October 6th, right?
Or is it?
October 27th. Have you watched this fight more than once? The Canelo Triple G first?
Twice.
And you scored it the same way twice?
Yeah, 7-5-3. You saw in the beginning where I did see you. Like, I didn't put nothing on. I didn't want to put the mark. But you was beating a lot with this show, right? You try to hook, you try to punch, and so I would go over here, pop, pop it right in your muscle, and boom, and he did it again, pop, it's holding down, hold on, like, you know, in that position, like, you always catch the guy up here, but a lot of the time, if I come up here, you can slip it, like, all right, like, you can just pivot, you can slip over here, boom, and I miss it, but you can't flip your arm, so the arm's coming, pop, so, see that, Joe?
Yeah.
But you got your head in, Joe, right here. Pop.
Yeah.
And yeah. Yo, right here.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's a little trick shit where, like, wow, I took your jab away early. Pop. Pop. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So I popped you there, like, three times.
That's what I was just telling you, man.
Hey, but that's nice of you.
Yeah.
That's nice of Gabe to share knowledge.
Yeah.
Gabe was good people.
Like, when I'm boxing you, I keep going the same way. You're not stopping me. You're following me. So you think you walking me down? Because you're coming on your front foot. That's following me. But now, if I step over here, walk with your back foot. See how you cut me?
Yeah.
So like if you fight me and I'm following you with my front foot, all that's gonna do is leave me in a circle to you. If I gotta meet that boom, boom, the back foot. You know what I'm saying? Because a lot of times when you think back foot, you think you're stepping back. It's the
cut off.
It's not that you're taking this step, you're taking that step. So you cut me off. You go to jab on this way. Boom, I can walk with you. But then I'm gonna take a step back and come over here. And then obviously you're going to step over here, I'm talking to him.
Actually running.
Kenny, who's the best in boxing and cutting off rings?
Nah.
Because a lot of fighters don't know how to do it. They don't do it. We've seen it.
Who's that? Cut them off. It's easy to step over.
No, but who does it the best right now from the pros?
Who does the best?
Who's the best at cutting off the ring?
I think you got to get that fighter, G.
Gennady Golovkin.
Yeah, I was gonna say that.
Okay.
He put pressure. His pressure is pressure. He cut you off. It's like he ain't following you.
But here's the thing. Yeah. When people complain, oh, my opponent was running. Well, if you cut off the ring, he can't run, right?
But that's a manipulation to the fans. That's just punking people that don't know about boxing.
They're not running.
That's what that is. Oh, he's running.
How you running?
This is running when you're doing. Zach, that's running. Boxing, you take.
Running. Running is what McGregor did when he fought Nate Diaz. When he turned his back and he physically was running, and they was like, "F you, come back."
Yeah.
That was running.
But yeah, it's not running. It's boxing.
No, okay. When you're in the 11th round, the 12th round, and
Canelo
the fighter
got those type of legs to even run if he wanted to run. I mean, Canelo got big, thick legs. The most he can move is what you see. I mean, Canelo can't do this.
No.
He can't move his feet like that. He doesn't have that type of that type of structure. Look, if you look at the fight, you're not running.
Have you seen this? I've never seen anything like this in my life.
What? What is it?
Who would show that? No, but why would you show it? Why would you want people to know and see it?
I get sponsored by it.
You know what I thought? So there you have it, another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter, @Seckbach. And you can follow me on Instagram, @Elie Seckbach.